Hey guys, Master Gaia speaking, and today I'm going to see a World War II reenactment with two of my friends. This guy's one of them. The guy in the blue shirt right over there is the other. It's actually a... So today is actually going to be a World War II reenactment. My dad's with us. And yeah, so I think it's going to be awesome. So, yeah. Hey guys, I'm back. I'm going to do a little quick review of the whole battle we're in at. Field is going to be so freaking awesome. Bam, 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 bam.
Dang it!
I'm not gonna clear here because it's too dangerous. And I'm very upset. Anything within a 4-block circumference, that weapon will penetrate. Cars, buildings, safes. Nothing is safe from this weapon. In World War II, we armed our ground troops with it. We put it in all our aircraft. We put it on our ships. It was an amazing weapon. It did the job. Again, air-cooled, full automatic, M250. Now this is going to be one of the loudest things you see. Also get your camera ready. Stretch your piece.
Go. Hit record.
Good job. Thank you.
Oh,
trench gun,
that's a trench gun.
Yeah, trench gun.
I'm back.
Trench gun.
By the end of 1943, we had stopped the Japanese advancement. And we thought we had them on the run. But they were digging in. We were encountering a new threat. The threat was defensive fortified positions. We had to create a way to get in there. Now, a defensive fortified position can be as simple as just a reinforced gun emplacement. Or a machine gun bunker known as a pillbox. Command bunker, flagpole, the big one. However, the most difficult were the reinforced caves that went back thousands of feet. We had to get them out. The Marine Corps devised an engineered assault team. Why engineered? Because the weapons they carried were specialized and only organic to the engineer battalion. A team was composed and team was attached. One team per platoon with the assaulting companies on the first wave of the anthrax. Team composed of 5 to 6 men. First man was the leader. He was in charge of the team. He usually carried the automatic weapon. He was the brains of the team. He analyzed the battlefield and directed his team. Next man is the flamethrower operator. This man carried an M2-2 flamethrower. Now, this weapon weighs about 68 to 70 pounds, fully loaded. burn, it will suffocate, it will blind the enemy. And a note here, this is the only weapon that we have on the battlefield today that does not fire blanks. What you see is what they got, and it's ugly. Let's talk about burning. Flamethrower will shoot out a flame about 20 to 40 yards. However, there is a limitation. He only has 6 to 10 seconds of fuel, give or take a few seconds of fuel, and he's out. You really have to watch that trigger squeeze. Once he's out, he has to go back, get new tanks, and get refilled. However, the flame that he shoots out, we don't carry temperature gauges, but it's about 2,000 to 3,000 degrees Fahrenheit.
That is hot.
Suffocation. Well, those guys that don't get burned, they're going to honker back in there, kind of hide. Hey, that's okay. No problem. We're going to stick the nozzle in the enclosure and try to use up all the oxygen inside that cave. And then we're going to replace the oxygen with deadly carbon monoxide. That's a poisonous gas that will cause casualties. And lastly, it's called blinding. Late in the war, when they saw him coming, they couldn't take him out. They couldn't run away. They tried to close all their openings. Made our job a lot easier. They couldn't see us, but we sure could see them. Now, how does it work? Flamethrower has two groups. One is called the tank group. On the back, he has three tanks. The two large tanks contain flammable fuel, gasoline, aviation gasoline, diesel. You can put a thickener in there and make a gel called napalm. Higher heat, better accuracy. Small tank is compressed air and nitrogen. Once you turn the screw, the entire system is under heavy pressure. The gun group. You have the fuel hose, the valve lever, which will release the gas or release the liquid under pressure. You can saturate, spray your target. The trigger will light a pilot light. You have the flame, and of course your nozzle, better to direct your flame. Now his nickname is Blowtorch, but he's only half the job on these bunkers. The other half is a guy called Corkscrew. Today, Corkscrew carries a statue charge.
But he's saying that. Too bad.
Thank you.
He's going. Oh my fucking god.
Settle!